Hello friends, welcome to chapter 6, and in this chapter we learn how to commit and push the code in two steps. So what we will do is, let me just write here, I think it's already here. So in the first part we'll see how to commit your code changes, commit the code change into the local repository, and then we'll see how to push the code from local repository to your GitLab account in your remote repository. Okay. So that we'll do in two steps. One is, first we'll see how to commit, and then we'll see how to push the code changes from your local repository to remote repository. Okay. So without wasting any further time, let me go and open Eclipse. So here is IDE. Let me just close everything here. So now what I will do is, I'll make some code change here. Okay. Let me just go to the login page. If you guys remember, in the last video, we created this particular UI. Now if you see here, there was no validation. So what I'm going to do is, I'll just go and make some code change here. So let me go to the login page, and what I will do is, I'll just write some code here. Okay, so what I will do is, I'll just write here, if get user get user ID is not null and get password is not null, then only let allow the user to go to the welcome page. So now if you see, I have changed the code a little bit. I have used string utils dot is blank method. What it does is, it basically checks for this particular value, that this particular value should not be null or blank. So this particular method takes care of both null and blank values. And to make use of this one, if you see here in my import, you will see I have used apache commons dot lang. So this is my jar file, and I have used string utils class, which is there in this particular jar file. Now if I expand my lib, you can see I have added one more library, apache commons dash lang3. Okay, now if I'll run this particular thing, so here is my screen. If I don't add anything and simply click on login button, you'll see I'm there only, because this particular piece of line, it's verifying things. There should be something in the ID, there should be something in the password, then only it will take you to the welcome page, else you will stay there on the login page. Okay, now I'm going to enter something. For example, I'll write ABCD, and my password, I'll type password 1234 something, and I click on let me just check, and click on login. Now you see I'm there, we are at the welcome page now, and this is my ID, and here is my password, here is my checkbox, right? So this is how it is. Now in this part, what we did is, like, we added a validation, we have just simply made some code change here, right? Now let's commit this code into the remote repository. Now if you will see, if we go here, so here is our project on GitLab, and if you will go and expand the web content, you will see here that we have only one library. So if we push the code, we should see one more library, Apache Commons, right? And there is some code change as well in our login.java class. Now if you will see, as of now, if I go and open my login.java class, you won't find anything inside this welcome method, but if you see on local copy, we have added some validation. Okay, now let's go and push the code. So what I will do is, in this video, if you see here, the agenda of this video is to learn commit and push one by one in two different clicks. Okay, so what I will do is, here I'll simply go to the project, right click on the project and team, then go to the commit. Now if you are here, as I told you earlier, in your stack changes, there you will see your change file. So as part of this change, we have updated faces config and login.java. Okay, let me just take this up. And apart from this, I also added my library, a new jar file. Now commit message, as I told you earlier, commit message is very important, and if you want that, it will ask you, it will give you a prompt to enter password. So now I'm going to write a commit message. So basically you can write here, added validation to verify user ID and password. Sorry, so your commit matches should be meaningful. Okay, now what I'm doing is I'm going to click on commit. So commit will, it will basically commit the code change in my local repository. It won't promote to the remote repository. Okay, let's do that. Commit is done. So you have committed the code change. Okay, now if you will go and see here, you won't find any change here. Your login bean, your welcome method is as it is. No change. Why? Because we haven't pushed the code into the remote repository. That we'll see now how it works. So you can just close this one and now just again go back to your project, right click, click on team, and then you see there is an option push branch master. So what it will do is this particular click will push your code from your local repository to your remote repository. Let me just click on push again. It says I'm going to commit the code into the master branch. You say okay, preview. Again, you need to enter your ID and password. If you want, you can ask us to memorize your password. You need to click this checkbox. But for now, I'm okay. Okay, I hope my password is correct this time. It's good. Let's push. They're asking me to enter my ID and password one more time. Let me see if I'm entering correct details or not. Login. Now you can see here, right? It's pushing code changes. Go. Okay. It's done. So let's first verify here only. Right click on team. So right click on the project team. And then you click here. What do you call it? Synchronize your workspace. Yes. Okay, let's check this out here. Okay, so we are good here, we are in sync. Let's go and verify the code changes. Just go to the project. Now what I will do is, so we have committed the code change, right? What would it be? Right click on the team and then push branch master. Okay, now let's go and see if we have the new code here in the remote repository. Just refresh, login page. Now you can see here is our new code here. String utils dot is blank. If it is not blank, then only navigate the user to the next screen. Let's go and verify the jar. If we have here trade link, because I'm expecting a new jar file here, web.inf, let's go to the lib folder. Now you see here common links, right? Now you see here it is. So we have successfully committed the, we have committed, or you can say push the code from remote, from local repository to remote repository. Okay, if you will click on the project, you will see the latest commit message here. Added validation to verify user ID and password. This is how it works, right? I hope you guys understood. If you have any issues, if you have any doubt, just let me know in the comment section. So in this video, we have covered how to commit code changes in two processes. Like one is just commit into local repository and then push the code from local to remote repository. That is here on GitLab. Thank you for watching. Bye for now.